Hi, Eagle artists, and welcome back to your art day. This week, we will continue our collage unit, and we will learn another way to make our collages look awesome, even better than last week. This way is called balance. It is another important art concept. In this video, I will go through the slides with you to learn how you can use balance in your next collage. Let's start. Again, let's think about why. What is balance? How can we use it? But even more than that, let's think about these questions. How do artists make the viewers of their work feel sure that the art piece is finished and complete? How do artists make their viewers feel comfortable or calm when looking at their artwork? And like last time, how does knowing this kind of art words or concepts help us to understand other works of art and help other people to understand our works of art? So let's explore. What is balance? Balance is kind of the opposite of what we did last week with emphasis. Artists use balance to make their artwork look complete and easy to enjoy the whole artwork. Think of a scale where the weights on each side are equal. Balance may also be called equal visual weight. And a way to find balance or to know if you have balance in the artwork is to ask yourself these questions. Does the artwork feel stable? Do my eyes move around the piece equally or get stuck on something? If your eyes move around the whole piece and they spend about as much time on everywhere, then you have balance. If your eyes get stuck mainly on one part, well, you probably don't have balance. The good thing about balance in artwork is that we like balance, it looks nice, and a balanced artwork will feel comfortable, complete, and calm. We may not realize why, but when we see a balanced artwork, we often say it looks nice because our eyes like balance. So let's move on to some ways to make balance. The strongest and most obvious way to make balance is to make things in your collage symmetrical. Symmetrical, just like in math or geometry, means that it's equal on both sides. Here in my little example, I have two orange triangles. On each side of the page, they are equal. They are the same size and the same color. So this is balanced symmetrically. Another way, which is a little more complicated and also more common, is to make parts balanced in how we call an asymmetrical way, which means that it seems equal on each side when the parts are added up. It might not be symmetrical, but it's still balanced. How? Could be like this. Like here we have a big blue triangle on one side, but here we have three small blue triangles. The amount of blue is about equal. If I added all of these up into one, they might be about the same as this one. This is another way to make balance. And the last way, which is not so common, but it is also nice, is to make it balanced from a central point, from the middle out. This is called radial balance. We are probably going to use mostly symmetrical and asymmetrical balance. I like these little illustrations that remind us of the three types of balance. So you can go back to these in the slides if you want a review while you're working on your collage. Symmetrical balance is exactly the same on each side. Asymmetrical balance is not exactly the same, but it equals about the same amount of each thing, even if they're not in the same place. And radial balance is balanced out from the middle. Okay, so these are three great ways to make balance and to make your artwork seem finished, complete, and comfortable to look at. So let's try to find some balance in artwork. Here we have a nice collage from Georges Braque. And let's see what kind of balance does it have. First of all, try to find a part or parts that are symmetrical. They are the same on both sides. We actually have three. The patterned wallpaper is equal on both sides. This wooden wooden shelf is about the same on both sides, and we have a wavy table leg on both sides. So there's a lot of balance here. Is there asymmetrical balance? I think yes. Up at the top, we have this kind of background area where there's equal amounts of black, but they're not on the same level. One is up and one is down. There's about an equal amount of green, but one is up and one is down. So that's asymmetrical balance. And if you look even more carefully, there's a lot going on in the middle, but we also have one big object with a shadow here on the left and one big object with a shadow on the right. They are not the same object, but they're still balanced because they're about the same size and they have the same colors. Light and dark, light and dark. And then if you look even closer, you might find that in the front, it's balanced too because we have a small kind of yellowish beige object over here and another small couple of objects over here that balances each other with about the amount and size of what they are. Okay? So these are really nice balanced artworks. And let's try another one. Here we have a very old famous artwork. What kind of balance does it have? And why? I find symmetrical balance in the small buildings that is the same type of building and size of building on each side, the red boxes, and the fact that there is a group of people in the right and the left in the front that are about the same size. If you look farther back and you see the groups of people that are smaller, those are asymmetrical balance because they have about the same amount of people, but over here the people are moving around and spread out, and over here the people are standing in a line. Still balance in an asymmetrical way. Let's try one with Frida Kahlo, our own famous Mexican artist. And I love this painting of Frida because it has both symmetrical and asymmetrical balance, which makes it look really finished and nice. Can you find the symmetrical balance? What is the same on both sides? We have one butterfly on each side of her head, and we have one black animal, which is about the same size on each side of her neck. We also have the bird, which has equal wings on each side, and you could also say that her face is symmetrical, same on both sides, just like everybody's face. How about asymmetrical? We also have these green leaves, which are about the same amount of leaves, on the right and the left, but the left ones are higher and the right ones are going down lower. If you'd like to find out more about this painting, in the slides you can click the link that I put there. And finally, let's do one of your guys' favorite artists from last year, Yayoi Kusama, who made those awesome spotted pumpkins. Does this artwork have balance, and what kind? Well, it's not symmetrical, it's not the same on both sides, but we do have asymmetrical balance. The colorful stripes are on the left lower down and on the right higher up. And the same for the red. Over here it's on the top and it's more thin, and over here on the bottom it's more large. And here we also have the other kind of balance that we haven't seen yet, radial balance, where things are balanced out from the center. Okay, so for the sake of time, let's go on to see again my example and the other example from a student, Paulette in 5G, that we saw last week with emphasis. Last week we said that the emphasis over here was on the word music, because it was colorful and big in the center, and the word love because it had a big pink heart. But now we're looking for balance. An artwork can have emphasis and balance. And I'm noticing that something balanced is the drawings that she did, the black and white drawings. They are in different areas. There's two on this side, there's two on that side, and there's one in the middle. So that does give her artwork a feeling of being finished and makes us more calm when we look at it. For mine over here, the art one, I had an emphasis on this big art tool cup and this bigger spot of color of painting. So those are my emphasis that we found last week. Do I have balance? The balance would be the way that I moved the colors around the whole piece. Purple is everywhere. Green, there was a big green kind of quote here. And then I put a big green shape down here and a smaller green shape over here. So I would have about the same amount of green in every part. And I did kind of balance this one, because it has all the colors bright together. So I found this paper that was colorful, kind of with the same colors, and I put it over there. So this one and this one balance each other. Okay? So you can use balance in your artwork by balancing the colors, by balancing the words, by balancing the type of things you put. For example, drawings could be balanced while words could be not balanced. It's really up to you. But now let's see what is our assignment for the week. Your new collage assignment is going to be a choice theme again. Yay! Choose a new topic that you'd like to work with, but your challenge this week is to make sure that you use balance in your collage artwork. And you will need to explain when you turn it in, how did you use balance on the share slide? If you need help, let me know. And you can also go back to view this video again or work with the slides. Take care, and I'll see you soon.